Hello there, this is Mr. Fingless and Talking Hands from Bad English Rex. And actually, I already made this beginning for this video once, but then my camera just stopped recording. Then I thought, okay, it's recorded it, but now I'm editing right now. Well, editing, and there is the file, but it doesn't work. So let's start again. This video is contest entry for Vinyl Guru. She has great channel, and I have something to show you. And there are five records, and I'm going to talk about them. Link over her channel is over there. And Vinyl Guru, it looks like you have you know how to what to wear. And you have taste for your music, so I thought maybe you are also, you have taste what kind of food you eat. So I'm going to show first. Have a break, have a Kit Kat. But look close. Closer? Is this close enough? Sakura Japanese sake. Maybe you would like, or maybe not. Japan is country for Kit Kat. They have so many flavors, Kit Kat, and some comes and then goes away. Just short time. But hey, this isn't about Kit Kat, this is about music, I hope. First album is Donna Summer, artist that I love, but actually this is one of those artists that I started buying accidentally. I saw, actually this is the first album I bought from her, and I saw it cheap and I bought it. I guess, yeah, I know the new song I Feel Love. And it's here, and this, but I like it. Actually, now I have two of them, and reason that I have two of them, I made video that some time ago about the big haul where I got many. For me, it was the biggest buying of album that I have got free from someone to myself, and I made a video about it, and I think this was the Donna Summer that was also there, but I haven't played that. I have been playing this. I think this is more at least cover is more worse, this ring wear. And then to the video that I already did. It's pretty used song, but if you want to hear some different version from it, go to listen I Feel Love, Kingston Wall, Finnish psychedelic rock or something like that. Was isn't there anymore, but I like probably how Giorgio Moroder has been producing these albums, and this was from 77, I guess, and first album, yeah, 77, and first album, if I remember right, was from him with Don Summer in 74, so 3 years before this, and their last was in this row was in 1980, so 3 years later. Casablanca record, I just listened this, I still like it. Maybe, I don't know, I like it, and I would say that also people who don't like disco or something like that, listen again, and listen how it sounds. I have to say, I sometimes, like, Sorry, I didn't remember now your name. YouTube channel I commented, he was mentioning some artist and I went to listen artist, but I couldn't listen artist because I was listening the sound of bass. It wasn't anything special, but it was good. Then, because I'm Mr. Finglish, of course I have to have something Finnish. And this I have been mentioning many times because this has been my album that I have been liking to listen, especially when after I got it. It is Insomnium, Heart Like Grave. It is a really melodic death metal album and beautiful, atmospheric, and go to listen, especially, let's say, Pale Morning Star. It's a beautiful song and it has a beautiful images from Finland and like video image, and it's beautiful and beautiful music and beautiful image. And don't be afraid, even though it's have really growling vocals and that kind of stuff. First, it Pale Morning Star, it starts really like acoustic way, but then it comes or something like that, more like yeah. Beautiful album and should be more, even more known outside of Finland. They have had tours also outside of Finland, but right now, of course, and band that should be mentioned even more. I felt that in some news there was written like Ozzy Osbourne's drummer, but hey, Lee Kerslake. Yes, he was a drummer for Ozzy Osbourne, but he was more years in Uriah Heep, musical important. This, I think, like Kai Hansen from Helloween, Iced Earth guy, whose name I just forgot, he had mentioned also that Uriah Heep was important to them. And I think also that Blind Guardian, a guy, maybe mentioned also. In for that kind of power metal, Uriah Heep has been also one of the reasons. Of course, not the only one. And in the beginning of the 70s, the harmonies that they did with vocals, it was kind of new thing. And this is really, really beautiful. Some people may, because they was progressive rock, but they were also really pop, some songs. So for progressive rock guys, for some it was too pop, and for pop guys maybe too progressive, but I don't know. I love it. I love it. I just listened to their album with a Flying Gun, because in my memory I just remembered that I don't like the album so much, but I listened then it and I realized that it was only artwork I didn't like so much. And even artwork, Flying Gun, maybe over there, it's still fun. But if you compare it to this Magician's Birthday album, this has awesome, awesome artwork. Same guy did also for Yes and other bands in 70s. Go to listen Uriah Heep if you haven't. Listen more careful. It isn't just Easy Living and Lady in Black. There's more complicated songs also. Go to listen songs like I Love a Sunrise, Rain. They are kind of easy songs. But then listen also Magician's Birthday. It's 10 minutes song.
Was number
3, but not in order, any order. Then let's take some Finnish. This Ipsticker says it well. Outsider folk music. H.C. Slim, and also this cover artwork tells a lot. Really, I would say lo-fi and simple, little bit grotesque, dark folk music. And I love it. This is in English. Normally he sings in Finnish, like in with his own name, Joosa Keskitalo, but this is good way to start. But if you're into foreign languages and you don't have to listen everything in English, go to listen also his solo stuff, Joosa Keskitalo. But yeah, awesome stuff. I love. And also this was in on my record player on some point quite much, and I was happy to find also his first album on CD, because it was already sold out. But Anter Lindgren, Blood Red, and this is just, well, check out the artwork. In some way, they are like same family, if you look. Well, not they're not looking like same, I'm not saying that. But he has an awesome voice, vocals. I like his vocals. And this is like, this, again, artwork describes well. This would be really well for fall eve, this time year, to drive car and it's getting dark and you listen his music. It works. I would like to say even more, but I just realized that even though I wasn't saying almost anything, got some time for me. So sorry. But hey, Vinyl Guru, if you ever have chance to taste Kit Kat Sakura Japanese Sake, do it, do it. You will. I don't know, would you love it? But hey, you don't know if you don't taste. Have a break. Have a Kit Kat. Bye bye.